My name is Thomas E. Devine. I live in West Haven, Connecticut. I was involved in Earhart matter on the island of Saipan on four instances. I saw her plane. I saw the person who was in charge of destroying the plane. I saw markings on a Japanese jail cell indicating her presence. I was shown a grave site by a Native Island woman that contains the remains of a white woman and a white male who had come from the sky.
My name is Robert E. Wallach, and I'm going to talk to you about Amelia Earhart and me finding the briefcase in 1944. One of the guys knew quite a bit about demolition. It was a demolition guy. And we had some explosives, and we packed the door of the safe and blew the doors off. And Wallach was probably the first one at that when the smoke cleared off. And I looked in and grabbed the briefcase. And I thought, well, it's full of money. I'm going to be a rich Marine. But it wasn't. It was just as good or better. I grabbed it and ran off with it and opened it up. And lo and behold, it was Amelia Earhart's papers off her airplane, her briefcase she had on the airplane. I may have been just 18 or 17 or just turned 18 that month. And I said, there's something wrong, Wallach. These things are bone dry. 1938, they told me she crashed in the, they told us that she crashed in the ocean off the Howland Islands. They would have been wet. They're not wet. They're dry. I could see passports and visas and everything else that was there.
Julius Neighbors, I'm from Ball, Mississippi. I want to tell you something about a little bit about what I've done in the Marine Corps in World War II time. That's when the message came over the radio, and I went went and got it and decoded it. It said we had found Amelia Earhart's airplane at Acelito Airfield. And I carried it to the colonel. He signed it, and I brought it back and put it in the evening, about 6 o'clock or somewhere right along in there, I was on the message center and said, there's a message come through over from the island, the people out in charge of the place there, send pack or something. It said that tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock, you're going to fly Amelia Earhart's airplane. I said, well, this is history. I said, we got to see this. I told my guy pretty close to it in the mess center. So we said, George, that's George Gilbert, he's in the wire section, and he could get a Jeep because we had to run the wire lines and things. So we got around and we left. We went down with the hangar down in, and had some there's some tall grass grew there. So we poured the Jeep out in this grass. We covered it up where it could be seen by the airplane fly over. Then we crawled out to the airfield, edge of the airfield, and laid down. We waited till over about 2 or 3 hours there, and we decided they weren't going to. That next day there, this message came over, said tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock, we're going to destroy Amelia Earhart's airplane. Well, that was still pretty interesting news. So we did the same thing, went down, hit her Jeep, got out, crawled out, and down to her right, about 150 yards, 100 yards, about 150 yards, there were some guys that appeared, they were Marines, had on the Marine uniform, we called them the utilities of the day, and had four or five gallon cans sitting around. And a little while in, here came a Jeep pulling this airplane down. It was in the hangar. They pulled it across the, was a little bit of slope. I presume it was somebody and hit had to break, pulled it across the airfield and pulled it down and parked it.
Can you describe what it looked like?
Yeah, it was a, well, it's that casino, the type of airplane, you know, that had, single wing airplane, best I can remember it, single wing airplane. But they crawled up on top of it and poured three or four cans of gas, I mean, the wings and motors, I mean, the one end to the other, stood up on it. And then, directly here come a P-38. And you know, ever so many bullets or tracers. And it come down behind the plane. The plane is headed, of course, right where we was at. He come from the opposite direction, firing from the back of the plane, back of the plane, you know, that's down. And when it hit that fluid and everything, these other guys had got out of the way. It went up in a big smoke and fire. I mean, it was a humongous fire and smoke. Well, we weren't supposed to be there. And we'd realized that there's a lot of secrecy about it. So we got out. I have no doubt that what it wasn't Amelia Earhart's airplane. Because of the circumstances and the way it was brought about, the way it was handled. I don't know the cause of why they didn't make it public, but there's a lot about those operations that never was made public.